Before we do that, we will assess the situation in Syria, because Russia has said today it is gravely concerned by those reports that Israeli warplanes have bombed targets in Syria close to Damascus. It has called the alleged attack a gross violation of the UN Charter. Syrian state television has been saying that the plane hit a military research center and that two people died. There has still been no official confirmation of the raid from Israel. The latest details, first of all, come from Beth McLeod.
The official Syrian account of what happened in the early hours of Wednesday was announced on state television. They say that Israeli jets flew in fast, below radar level, and bombed a military research center, killing two workers and causing damage to several buildings. Some Syrian rebel groups, however, dispute the government's version of events, saying their forces attacked the site. The Syrians describe the site at Jamraya, just northwest of Damascus, as a scientific center aimed at raising the level of self-defense. It's widely believed by analysts outside Syria that chemical weapons are stored there. The Syrian account contradicts earlier reports that Israeli jets had bombed a military convoy heading from Syria to the Lebanese border. Lebanon said that low-flying Israeli warplanes entered its airspace near Syria. The Associated Press quoted a US official as saying the targeted lorries were carrying anti-aircraft missiles. The Israeli government hasn't commented on these reports, but senior officials have said in recent days they're concerned about security risks from the north, both from an unstable Syria and from Lebanon, where Syrian chemical weapons and missiles could fall into the hands of Hezbollah. Queues formed around Israel and the West Bank on Wednesday for gas masks. The chief of the Israeli post office said that demand for them had surged in recent days because of government warnings about chemical weapons from Syria. Beth McLeod, BBC News.
Well, let's go live to Jerusalem and join the BBC's Wira Davis. What is being said, if anything, where you are, Wira, about this?
Nothing officially, and you wouldn't expect the Israeli government to comment officially on operational matters like this, even when there's plenty of evidence on the ground or intelligence to suggest that something has happened. It does seem there was, though, an Israeli airstrike on Wednesday, either against a military convoy carrying weapons from Syria into Lebanon, possibly destined for Hezbollah, or against this military research facility in the north of Damascus, as indicated by the Syrian government. Now, Israel has said previously it doesn't want to get involved, and it won't get involved in Syria's civil conflict unless it feels that the chemical and conventional weapons that Syria has might fall into the wrong hands, in which case Israel says it would attack. And it does appear now that that perhaps has happened. Nobody in Israel is surprised by it, although Israel has taken a gamble here, hoping that given the precarious situation in Syria, the Syrian government, the Syrian Air Force won't respond.
All right, Wira, I know you'll keep us up to date. Thanks for now, Wira Davis in Jerusalem.
King News.